Hello everyone. In the last lecture, we have learned about different op-amp parameters and its specification. Also, we have seen the pin configuration of op-amp. So, out of these parameters, one of the main parameter of op-amp is open loop gain. Open loop gain. So, some of the characteristics of op-amp are frequency dependent. So, one of the most important of these characteristics is the open loop gain. Open loop gain. It can be denoted like this A and suffix open loop gain. So, what happened? As frequency increases, there may be changes in the characteristics. So, which parameter will change because of frequency? In that, main parameter is the gain. So, the gain decreases with increase in frequency in open loop gain, in open loop op-amp. So, if we draw the frequency characteristics or a frequency response of op-amp, then on x axis there is frequency parameter and on y axis there is gain. And open loop op-amp, open loop op-amp means what? There is no any feedback. There is no any feedback. So, in short, I will draw here diagram of open loop gain. So, this is minus plus, this is non-inverting, inverting amplifier, this is output. This is plus VCC minus VEE, plus VCC minus VEE. This is inverting input and this is non-inverting input. We are suppose applying input at inverting terminal of op-amp. So, this is suppose function generator we have connected with some frequency. Suppose 1 kilohertz is the frequency and 1 volt will be applied from function generator to the inverting terminal of op-amp. And in non-inverting terminal, we are connected one resistor R1 and we are make it as a ground. So, if we apply input signal and see the output at one particular frequency, you will get some voltage. But as you increase the frequency, there will be change in the value of voltage. So, that response means as frequency increases, what happened with the gain? This type of response is known as frequency response of op-amp. So, as frequency increases in the open loop, you will get this type of response. So, here if you see this frequency, this is 0, this is 5 hertz, okay, and this is 1 megahertz at which your gain becomes 0. So, at low frequency up to 5 hertz, you will get very high gain, very high gain. But as you increase the frequency, suddenly it will starts to fall down, right, and at 1 megahertz it will becomes 0. So, this is open loop frequency gain where bandwidth is very very low. So, if we see the bandwidth of this open loop form is 5 hertz. So, in order to accommodate the entire operating range of the gain of op-amp is calculated in dBs. So, this gain is in dBs, plotted, and it is plotted against the log of frequencies of the signal. When the gain of op-amp falls to unity, the unity gain bandwidth of practical op-amp is 1 megahertz. Unity gain bandwidth. So, unity gain bandwidth of op-amp is 1 megahertz. So, there is single break frequency, suppose F0, we can call this point as a F0 before unity gain bandwidth. Okay, so gain of op amp remains essentially constant from 0 to F0, that means up to 5 hertz, and thereafter roll offs at a constant rate of minus 20 dB per decade. This roll off rate means your gain starts to fall down, that rate is minus 20 dB per decade. So, thereafter roll offs at constant rate of 20 dB per decade, for 10 times increase in frequency gain falls by 20 dB, meaning of this minus 20 dB is what? That is 10 times increase, for 10 times increase in frequency gain falls by 20 dB, that is why it is minus 20 dB written here. Thus, the open loop bandwidth is here 5 hertz, which is very very less. Open loop gain is constant only up to first break frequency, this is constant up to only first break frequency, and therefore, the bandwidth of op amp is very very narrow. So, to increase the bandwidth for communication applications, we require more bandwidth. This is very less bandwidth. So, we cannot use such very less bandwidth for communication purpose. So, for increasing that bandwidth, we require negative feedback. So, op amp is a versatile device. For making op amp as a versatile device, a negative feedback must be used. So, if someone will ask you like what is the use of negative feedback in op amp, you can explain like this. In open loop for gain, in open loop form, op amp as frequency increases, gain of the op amp decreases by minus 20 dB per decade, and where for very less bandwidth your gain will be high. So, to increase the bandwidth, we have to use negative feedback, because ideally your bandwidth should be infinite. Okay, so the gain is same at all frequencies. Gain should be same at all frequencies. So negative feedback. What happens when you apply negative feedback? Negative feedback improves the performance of op amp when it is used to amplify AC signals. So, what are the advantages of negative feedback? First advantage, it stabilizes the gain. Second point, increases the bandwidth. Next, reduces the effect of input offset voltage at the output. Also, it reduces effect of temperature. And there are supply voltage variations also, that variations also can be reduced if we apply negative feedback. So, these are the benefits if we go for the negative feedback. Yes, So negative feedback is very necessary for improving the bandwidth of op amp. So if we apply feedback, then that type of configuration is known as closed loop frequency response of op amp. So closed loop means what? We have to apply feedback to our op amp. So the suppose I am applying V1 at inverting terminal, and then at non-inverting terminal I am applying one resistor R1, then V2 here applied, and then I am applying one resistor here in output. So these are the pin number 6, this is pin number 2, pin number 3, plus VCC at pin number 7 and minus VEE at pin number 4, okay, and this resistor is suppose RF, feedback resistor. So we have connected one resistor from this output side, pin number 6, to pin number 2. That means we are applying here feedback. So in the last point in open loop response, we have seen that maximum useful frequency is very, very less. That means bandwidth is very, very less. So to improve the bandwidth, we have to use negative feedback. Okay, so it uses feedback resistor network forming a non-inverting amplifier for input V2 equal to 0. Here we are keeping V2 equal to 0 and inverting amplifier for inverting input V1 equal to 0. Okay. So, closed loop voltage gain of circuit can be written as AV is equal to AO divided by 1 plus AV into beta. So, AO is what? Open loop voltage gain, beta is feedback ratio. When the denominator, that is 1 plus AO beta is equal to 0, the circuit becomes unstable. As this denominator becomes 0, circuit becomes unstable and that leads to sustained oscillations. So, rearranging and have the loop gain represented by minus A0 beta equal to 1. So, magnitude, if we take magnitude of this, then AO beta equal to 1. Okay. So, beta is constant if only resistive components are used and hence it does not provide any phase shift. Okay. AV into beta equal to 1, so circuit is unstable. Unstable if it is in open loop form. Then for closed loop response, here we have to apply input V1 or V2. If we apply V1, then that circuit is known as non-inverting amplifier, and if we apply V2, then that circuit is known as inverting amplifier. So, consider we are using inverting amplifier. So, in inverting amplifier, here suppose instead of 0 volts, we are using here 1 volt, okay, and 1 kilohertz frequency. 1 kilohertz frequency, and this circuit will act as a inverting amplifier. So, what happened with the response of gain? So, gain response curves after applying input to the op amp will represent the closed loop response of op amp. So, in closed loop response of op amp, you will get response like this. This is our main open loop response, this is up to 1 megahertz and this is 10 raised to 5 gain, which is gain in dB, and this is frequency in hertz. Okay. So, this is our open loop, means when inputs are not applied, open loop gain of op amp. Okay, the both inputs are 0. Now, when I am applying input V2, that means it acts as an inverting amplifier, then you will get response like this, and this gain will be 10 raised to 2, and this is known as FCL, closed loop frequency, and this frequency is known as FOL, open loop frequency. So, closed loop frequency here can be up to 10 kilohertz, up to 10 kilohertz. So, see the bandwidth, this is the bandwidth up to 5 hertz for open loop response, and here up to 10 kilohertz for the closed loop response. So, here we can say that in closed loop op amp, your bandwidth increases, okay. Bandwidth increases, and this bandwidth is very much useful for communication applications. Okay. So, if the feedback registers are changed, the closed loop gain will change to a new value. These are the feedback registers. Suppose RF/R1 we change, then it will change to the new value, and so will the closed loop cutoff frequency also change. Since the gain bandwidth product is constant, the closed loop curve superimposes on the open loop curve beyond cutoff frequency. So, specification sheets normally present manufacturer's plot of open loop gain versus frequency with the point F unity indicating where A is 1. So, specification called transient response or unity gain, which is typically 0.2 microsecond to 0.8 microsecond at maximum for 741 op amp. So, bandwidth determined from the rise time specification. If specification is given that rise time is from the specifications, if you want to calculate bandwidth, then we can calculate bandwidth like this. Bandwidth is equal to 0.35 divided by rise time. 0.35 divided by rise time. So, from that you can calculate bandwidth by using the specifications of op amp, and also bandwidth is equal to A into F, where A is the open loop gain of op amp, and frequency of operation F provides the total bandwidth. So, suppose A is 100 at frequency of 15 kilohertz, then what is the bandwidth? Bandwidth is equal to 100 into 15 kilohertz, that means 15 into 10 raised to 3 hertz. So, your bandwidth will be 1.5 megahertz. Okay. So, in this way, from given specifications, we can calculate the bandwidth of op amp. So, op amp and a few registers form an amplifier, and frequency response depends on frequency response of op amp. The voltage gain of op amp decreases at high frequencies. This is due to the parasitic junction capacitance and minority carrier charge storage in devices making up the circuit. This aspect of op amp is characterized by next parameter, which is known as gain bandwidth product. Which is the bandwidth of op amp when voltage gain is unity? So, equivalent term for gain bandwidth product are, we can say it as a closed loop bandwidth, unity gain bandwidth, or small signal bandwidth. So, unity gain bandwidth is similar to the gain bandwidth product, gain bandwidth product. Okay. So, for general purpose op amps, the gain bandwidth product is in the range of 1 to 20 megahertz. So, small signal unity gain bandwidth characteristics is an important parameter of an op amp. for an op amp with a single break frequency of f1, the unity gain bandwidth is equal to AO into F1, where AO is the open loop gain, F1 is the break frequency of op amp. So, a typical data sheet presents the unity gain bandwidth instead of corner frequency F1, and F1 can be calculated using the equation F1 is equal to UGB divided by AO. So, typical data sheet presents the unity gain bandwidth. So, in the data sheet, we will get unity gain bandwidth, and from that unity gain bandwidth, we can calculate break frequency. Okay. So, by using components in the feedback of op amp, you will form a closed loop response, and in that response, your bandwidth is more compared to bandwidth of open loop response. This is justified. Okay. So, this is about the frequency response in closed loop as well as open loop form of op amp. That is all for today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will go for the slew rate in detail. Thank you.